Hello everyone and welcome back to Around the World in 80 Planes and Next Plane 11. For this flight, I'm going from Kochi to Kansai Airport in Japan. Basically, Kansai Airport's the main airport for Osaka, though there's another Osaka airport. And I'm flying the venerable Cessna 172 with a reality expansion pack. So there's some additional reality features. But I didn't go through the startup procedure. I just had it start up automatically. Normally, the reality expansion pack makes the startup procedure a little bit more sophisticated, among other things. Anyway, frame rate should be pretty good, considering this is basically a stock airplane and, a rather slow one at that. The flight is only going to be 94 nautical miles, so we should be able to do that in an hour. I'm going to continue with the Apollo 13 audio. They are still on their way to the moon, though the disaster has already happened, so they're trying to figure out how to get back safely, and we continue with that. There we go. Alright, so, I don't... Well, we'll put a little bit of flaps. Okay.
Go ahead, you...
Okay, Jim, we've come up with a calm recommendation. Which we hope will save some power by powering down the power amplifier, if it works.
I put the throttle a little bit high for a current mixture.
I'd like to read up the steps to you and have you think about it for a minute. We recommend trying it.
It got off the ground a little bit earlier than I expected, but we aren't fully fueled, though, so there is that.
Okay, you can read up the steps.
Okay, step one. Biomed off. Step two, go to low bit rate. Step three, go to down voice backup.
I wonder if I need to update the reality expansion pack or something.
Power amp to prime. Step five, panel 16.
Well, we need to turn around.
Breaker open.
Oh, I'm capturing my cursor. I'm not supposed
step
to be doing
six.
That.
Range function switch off. Read those back to me and then I'll have a remark.
Okay, it's biomed off.
I think we could probably do the flight in here. I mean,
down voice backup. Power amp to prime.
Might be more scenic that way.
Trigger breakers. Panel 16, power amp, circuit breaker.
Normally I do it from outside. Well, I want to get more height. The texture is a little bit muddy at this height.
The note says that you should be able to hear us if we can't hear you in a couple minutes. You should close the power amp circuit breaker on panel 16. And we expect to save an amp or more on this. It should work in the present attitude. When we go to the new yaw attitude, we're thinking about powering up the steerable, leaving the power amp off, and if we can get good calm in that mode, we'll still save some power.
So
if you concur, why don't you go ahead?
Basically, they're trying to manage communications so that they save power, because it's all on the lunar module's batteries right now, and the fuel cells in the lunar module.
Okay, in this mode, you should hear us, or we should hear you, but can't hear us, then we ought to close the power amp circuit breaker again, is that right?
That's a firm. We'll just run a little comm check after you get done and see how we're doing.
And frankly,
okay,
that's going to be quite a pain.
We'll move back to our original configuration.
That's a firm.
Because their communication is going to be choppy and full of static. I cut out the major static parts, obviously. I had to listen to them, but I cut them out for you guys. So, we'll be getting a little bit of it, but again, it's going to be mostly cut out. There were some parts where it was a judgment call, whether you could or couldn't hear what they were saying. If it's like this, I left it in. Obviously. And even if it's a little bit harder to hear them. But there's a point where it crosses my personal line, and I I decided not to keep those bits in. I think 3,000 feet should be good as long as it clears those mountains over there. Maybe a little bit higher. Oh, mixture setting harmful. I have been adjusting the mixture, but I'm glad it's giving me information about that. That's the reality expansion pack as well. I think these are the reality expansion pack things. Mass imbalance. Obviously, when on the ground. Walk around is on the ground. Maintenance report. Yeah, mostly ground stuff. Like I said, mostly about startup and right at the beginning. I don't think we can follow this river to our right. Oh, sorry, to our left.
Okay. Step one.
I'm not sure.
Off. Step two. Go to low bit rate. Step three. Go to down voice backup. Step four. Power amp to prime. Step five. Panel 16, power amp circuit breaker open. Step 6, range function switch off. Read those back to me and then I'll have a remark.
Okay, it's biomed off, low bit rate. Down voice backup, power amp to prime, circuit breaker, panel 16, power amp, circuit breaker open, range function switch off.
Okay, and the note says
I should get higher resolution textures for Japan.
If we can't hear you.
I like flying around Japan anyway, and these aren't quite up to par.
The power amp, circuit breaker on panel 16.
If higher resolution textures are available, of course.
Should work in the present attitude. When we go to the new yaw attitude, we're thinking about powering up the steerable, leaving the power amp off, and if we can get good con in that mode, we'll still save some power. So if you concur, why don't you go ahead.
Okay, in this mode, you should hear us, or we should hear you, but if you can't hear us, then we've got to close the power amp circuit breaker again, is that right?
That's a firm. We'll just run a little time check after you get done and see how we're doing.
Okay, fine, and if that all fails, we'll go back to our original configuration.
That's a firm.
Oh, that sounds great, that comm configuration. Well, we can still sort of hear him. We're getting a little bit slower here. Going up a little bit because of the mountains. And take a look at the winds. Well, that's high level winds. They aren't great. Definitely aren't great.
Stay there for the next minute or two anyway, Jim. I'll be right here.
Well, lots of trees. That's a wonderful sound they've discovered.
This is Apollo Control. Rather noisy communications at the present time on the ground circuit.
The merciful public affairs officer.
Meanwhile, the spaceflight meteorology group of the Environmental Sciences Services Administration has issued forecasts that weather conditions would be satisfactory for Apollo 13's landing in the Pacific Ocean next Friday, April 17. Along the planned recovery line in the central South Pacific, skies will be partly cloudy with southerly winds at 15 knots. Seas up to 4 feet are expected, with temperatures near 80 degrees. Apollo 13 now 195,375 nautical miles out from Earth. Velocity 2,981 feet per second. At 65 hours, 27 minutes ground elapsed time, this is Apollo Control standing by. Program alarms, etc. And we recommend that in order
Got some nice shininess on my Cessna. You don't get as much of the metallic sense when the body is in full light, but on the shadowed portions, we get a bit more of that. Well, that's a formidable mountain range up ahead. We're headed towards Tokushima City, by the way. We're technically flying over Tokushima Prefecture. This dodgy. Can we get over that mountain range?
In the service module, liquid oxygen tank number 2 and fuel cells 1 and 3 failed shortly thereafter. A decision was made to scrub any attempt at landing and continue on a lunar flyby.
I'm probably managing the mixture a little bit wrong here.
Increased load on fuel cell 2 and the dropping pressure in the remaining liquid oxygen tank led to the decision to use the lunar module for a sort of lifeboat to come back to Earth using its consumables for life support.
You can see the effect of the wind here. I mean, 35 knot wind sideways when we're going 60 knots. Okay, we can descend a little bit now. A little bit.
The
mixture was rather low.
To re-enter the Earth's atmosphere in the Indian Ocean south of Mauritius, and about
but then that says harmful, but I see the engine gas temperature going up.
Another dips decent propulsion system burn is being planned at approximately
maybe that'll I guess that's what we have to go with.
With a velocity change
keep the engine gas temperature moderate,
which would bring the spacecraft home somewhat more rapidly. About 10 hours sooner, as a matter of fact, to splash down in the southwest Pacific at 142 hours north of New Zealand. And that's where the situation stands at the moment. We'll be handing over to the Gold Team shortly here in Mission Control. And at 65 hours, 49 minutes ground elapsed time, this is Apollo Control standing by. Aquarius, Houston.
Go ahead.
Okay, Jim, we have a handover coming up on the hour. That's in a minute and a half. On the hour, we would like you to turn the S-band transmitter.
That's a nice one. Nice shot right there. Oh great, the comms got even worse when they turned off the S-band receiver.
Roger, Jim. Nico is checking into what we can do, but the noise, it may be a problem with the site.
I think to our left is the Yoshino River and its valley. Lots of cities there. We should have probably followed that. But that was more northerly. We were on the south coast of Shikoku at Kochi. The Yoshino River goes along the north. Basically, to our left there, at our left wing, that city is called Mima. Roger. M-I-M-A.
Aquarius, Houston. We are going to try to improve the comm and telemetry by temporarily breaking lock and reacquiring. You may hear some noise in your headset.
This is Apollo Control. It's 66 hours, 37 minutes. Flight Director Glenn Blenny is still in the control center. We will notify newsmen on this line when he leaves.
Nice river.
MSC Auditorium.
On the south end of its mouth is Tokushima.
Is 197,424 nautical miles from Earth. Its velocity is 2,953 feet per second.
I can't hear anything from the spacecraft right now.
Okay.
Oh, there we go.
Houston, you want to bring your signature down 45 up again?
Aquarius, Houston, I don't think so at this time. Our voice is good now. How's yours?
Art.
Okay, why don't we stay where we are for a few minutes?
Okay, Houston, Aquarius, we're dead banding with new attitude.
Aquarius, Houston, roger that. Your comm is good.
This is Apollo Control. It's 67 hours, 23 minutes. Flight Director Glenn Lenny is still...
The city right in front of us down here is Yoshino River City, Yoshinogawa.
Meetings on the floor here since his ship changed. He and Flight Director Jerry Griffin. Director Flight Operations, Flight Crew Operations, Deep Sleep. Director Chet Lee, the Apollo Program Director Rocco Patron, and other management officials have been holding some discussions. We have no estimate on when Mr. Lenny will be able to get away at this time. We will attempt to summarize for you some of the discussions that have been going on here. We're still leaning toward the burn at Paracynthian plus 2 hours. That's the descent propulsion system burn at 79 hours, 27 minutes.
So again, that's 2 hours after they passed their closest point to the moon.
A number of people are taking a look at being termed a super fast return require a larger burn at paracentium plus an hour and a half. This would bring us to a splash time of 118 hours versus 142 hours. However, to accomplish this, we would have to jettison the service module.
Yeah, that's dangerous.
Preliminary data indicates that we may have a thermal problem on the way back without the service module. There's also some other aspects that need to be looked into. This option is being held open and is being worked and will be for the next several hours. However, as I say, all of the officials here are still leaning toward the paracentium plus 2 hour burn with 142 hour return. In connection with the super fast return, astronaut Gene Cern has been doing some work in the trainer on star visibility problems, manual reaction control, manual throttle work. And this option will be kept open for some time. Another problem with the super fast return is that we can't stand as much misalignment with the inertial platform on a long burn as we can on the 142-hour return. We, at present time, would feel more comfortable with the 142-hour return. We expect to be able to get a program 52 or a platform aligned.
So here we have Tokushima. And I think we'll go along the northerly route, so we'll head towards Awaji Island there that you can see. But we'll follow along the south coast of Awaji Island so that we get to Wakayama. That'll let us see more of Osaka before we land. Well, actually going north would be better to see more of Osaka now that I look at it. So we'll skip Wakayama and go north. Obviously, the city of Tokushima here, the photo scenery was taken in a different season than the surrounding areas. Alas.
Enough water to last to 155 hours ground elapsed time. In addition to that, we would have the water from the portable life support systems. The water use rate at the 17 amp, the power usage would be 2.68 pounds per hour. These projections also include the two power-ups for mid-course corrections on the way home. Procedure has been worked out to use the command module lithium hydroxide cartridge for CO2 removal. And we are presently yawing manually 90 degrees every hour for passive thermal control. After the burn, we may put a rate into the spacecraft, a roll rate into the spacecraft, and let it go to attempt to set up some type of passive thermal control. It doesn't require complete manual operation. The flight dynamics officer reports that if the burn is a reasonable one, the they would schedule a mid-course probably at 24 hours out instead of 12 hours. That would be a lapse time of 104 hours. Standby, please. And we expect communications to improve a little bit after S4B impact on the lunar surface. The S4B frequency is giving us a little trouble with this communications. After the impact, we will not have to turn the transponder in.
The runway to our right is Tokushima Airport.
During handover between tracking stations. That's the situation as it stands now. We'll keep you advised as to flight record money's availability. This is Mission Control Houston.
In front of us is the city of Naruto. Yes, Naruto. N-A-R-U-T-O. So there you go. I don't know if there's any connection or whether people do a pilgrimage to this place.
Aquarius, Houston, over.
I never watched Naruto, so I wouldn't know.
Go ahead, Houston.
Okay, Jim, in order to save an amp or two of power here, we'd like you to go to the down voice backup comm configuration, which is pulling the power amp circuit breaker and going to down voice backup. If we get into a comm problem, all you have to do is reverse that configuration and it should be good.
Okay, we'll go to down voice backup and pull the power amp circuit breaker. And if it gets in trouble, we'll come back again.
Okay, real fine, and we estimate the next yaw maneuver should start at about 6802. Over.
Okay, can you give me that in minutes?
I sure can. That's going to be in 29 minutes from now, Jim.
Okay, thank you.
You can basically follow the highway across Awaji Island.
Jim, Houston, roger that. You are readable through the noise. How are we?
Can I get somebody in at time? Work out the medical configuration, the event. Something happens, they're asking to make the turn. We have to get the band.
This is Apollo Control at 67 hours, 38 minutes. President Nixon talked with NASA Administrator Dr. Thomas O. Paine at 7:45 a.m. Central Standard Time today. Dr. Paine, who arrived in Houston by NASA aircraft at 6:40 a.m. Central Standard Time from Washington, was in Mission Control and gave the President an update on the Apollo 13 mission.
So, looking back at the Yoshino River there.
With the White House. We'll continue to stand by now for live air ground transmissions. This is Apollo Control at 67 hours, 43 minutes. The lunar module is configured in a box mode of communication. And what you are hearing is the crewmen talking among themselves. They are not calling Houston. We are not in air ground transmission, but you will be able to hear the crewmen talking among themselves when they are in this mode.
Yeah, but because they're not talking into the microphone, we can barely hear them, so a lot of this I cut out because it's just not audible.
This is Apollo Control at 68 hours, 13 minutes.
You can see the little traffic on the highway there, that's good. I like that. Definitely have to make some space for new Japan textures, though.
For a news conference accompanying Glenn Lenny will be Tom Weichel, the retrofire officer, Clint Burton, ECOM, Al Loden, Control, and Merlin Merritt, Telmu. This is Apollo Control at 68 hours, 17 minutes. An additional participant of the news conference will be Major General David O. Jones, United States Air Force, who commands the Department of Defense Recovery Forces. This is Apollo Control at 68 hours, 21 minutes. Apollo 13's distance from Earth now is 200,396 nautical miles. Velocity, 2,919 feet per second.
This is Houston, go ahead.
Maneuver complete.
Roger, Jim. We show you on telemetry. Looks solid at the new attitude. Just by way of information, the latest tracking data shows the Paris.
The map shows this highway as the E-28, the one that we're following here. In front you can see Osaka Bay, and right across is the city. In fact, at the moment we're basically pointed at the airport, which is on an island off the coast of the city. But we'll sort of take a loop around.
Copy that. First of all, you want to go through the circuit breaker by circuit breaker, careful power up procedure for the next steps burn. And we're working on that. Secondly, you want a procedure for powering the command module up again. Like you have to re-enter it and power it up. And we're talking about that and working on
So across the bridge from Awaji Island is the city of Akashi. It's the Akashi Kaikyo Bridge. And then shortly beyond that is the city of Kobe, which is a fairly large city. Struck by an earthquake, I think, in 1994. I've seen Japanese dramas about that. I think I see the bridge from here, maybe.
910 feet per second. We'll continue to stay up live for any air-ground transmissions.
Hopefully at some point in our loop the wind will actually be helping us. As we make our way around the bay.
70 hours, 24 minutes. A decision has been made to perform the Paracentian plus 2 hour maneuver. This will be a docked descent propulsion system burn of approximately 900 feet a second. And we'll bring landing in the Pacific Ocean at 142 hours elapsed time. We'll be passing up to the crew a procedure shortly for them to perform a sun check in the alignment optical telescope of the lunar module, so that we may better understand what the present LAM inertial platform alignment is. If as a result of this sun check the platform looks good, we will perform the maneuver without a platform realignment. If it does not look good, and the limits on this have been defined as plus or minus 1 degree, we will do what is termed an Earth-Sun option alignment before going into the dark behind the moon and set up the attitude of the spacecraft so that the crew can mark on a good star while they're in the dark to check Earth-Sun alignment that they would have performed previously. Apollo 13 now is 203,957 nautical miles from Earth. Velocity is 2,894 feet per second. Jim Lovell, the spacecraft commander, and Jack Swigert, the command module pilot, have just started a 6 hour rest period.
So from here you can see Akashi, and you can see Kobe in front of us there, with all the buildings and the island there.
Information on this decision up to the crew very shortly. This is Mission Control, Houston.
Kobe Airport is actually on the island to the right, the smaller one. There's a larger island that has buildings on it.
Time of this planned lunar module engine maneuver is approximately 79 hours, 25 minutes. We expect to do the sun check at about 74 hours elapsed time. We're now 6 hours, 36 minutes away from loss of signal when the spacecraft will go behind the moon. We'll stand by for any air ground now.
Let go of the stick for a moment and start deviating.
Okay, Fred, I have a few words for you on some things we want to do in the next few hours. And in order to get good comm for that, and also in order to get quiet on a few minutes of aging, I want to have you put the power amplifier circuit breaker on panel 16 in. Voice function switch to voice, and the ranging function switch to ranging, over.
Alas, I don't think the bridge is navigable by the AI cars, but still, nice rendition of the bridge here. Okay, turning towards Kobe. You can clearly see where the airport is. And again, this is all Osaka Bay in front of us.
Okay, stand by one. Okay, Joe, as I read that, 74 hours, we're going to do an AOT sun check at descent 2, which is going to require the rendezvous radar out of the way. And then we use CPD2 auto maneuver to get there. Or at least the angle out of that. And if this passes within 1 degree, your fan's platform is okay for the maneuver, and we won't need a subsequent CPD2. But even if it is okay, you'll give us a star, which we can use for our check when we're in darkness. The check pump. Your path is going up then in Earth, Moon, Alliance procedure.
Okay, Fred, that's correct, except that the Align procedure that we're working on is Earth, Sun, Align. And other than that, that's correct. Incidentally, this PC plus 2 maneuver looks like it'll still be around 900 foot per second maneuver. Get you back to the Pacific line at 142 hours.
Okay, that was an Earth sun check. Yeah, we're getting a little close to the moon now. And the PC plus 2 maneuver still looks about 900 foot per second to get us is in mid-pack at about 122 hours.
That's right. Aquarius, Houston.
Go ahead, Jim.
Okay, Fred, we've got a good batch of ranging, and now we'd like you to reverse the configuration. Ranging to off, voice function to now, voice backup, power amplifier, circuit breaker out, and we're talking to you.
Can't really hear him very well at this point. Anyway, this is Kobe. Somewhat known for its beef, I suppose. Nice little red bridge there.
Fred, this is Houston.
Roll left. Yeah. Go ahead.
Okay, Fred, I didn't copy the beginning of your message.
The island, the big one right here to our right, is called Port Island. It is just called Port Island. It's the Japanese use the English words written in katakana to refer to it.
Aquarius, Houston, over.
Go ahead, Joe.
Roger, listen, Charlie Good wants to talk to you about the AOT star check, and so that we can have good calm, I'd like to reconfigure.
It's certainly appropriately named.
Sounds like you broke out, Charlie.
Yeah, finally, Brito. No longer got the red spots.
I think Charlie Duke was the one who was replaced on the original crew because of measles. Let me double check that. I always mix things up, so always better to check. But I think that's what they're referring to. Oh, he was the backup lunar module pilot. He caught the measles. So he caught the measles, but he was on the backup crew. But then Ken Mattingly was on the main crew, but he was potentially exposed to it. So that's why he was replaced by Jack Swaggart. That's how it was.
And that'll throw us over to 6. And on the 5025, we want you to do the enter on the 5025. And that'll bring up flashing 0170. And load in R1.
This island to our right is Roko Island. It's got this nice Highway 5 with this fancy bridge here that acts as a causeway right around the bay. Though it seems to change its name to Highway 4 at some point. I don't know. Not clear to me. You can pretty clearly see downtown Osaka now, and the entire Osaka metropolitan area. Kobe is sort of off here.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, at sun half unit vectors, X, R1 is
quite a sprawl. We'll start descending now.
Okay, we pro on after entering the 200, we'll get a flash in 0688. We then load the sun unit vectors for...
The main river that Osaka is on is the Yodo River, which you can see in front of us, of course. I thought frame rate would be fine, but this is quite a busy area as far as objects are concerned. Sometimes the lag is just down to a single building that has, you know, excessive textures on it. I think you can sort of see the airport is actually at our right wing. It's way down south there. That's why I decided to go this way, because if we head south, then we wouldn't really, we'd have to double back in order to see the city.
For this maneuver, over.
Okay, well.
So this river right here is the Yodo River.
Roger, stand by. Aquarius, Houston, Fredo on that, to pass that check. The sun is at, will subtend an arc of 1/2 degree in the AOD, so you can be 2 diameters off and still pass the check, over.
I think that's a good enough view of the downtown area.
So we can be 2 sun diameters off and still pass.
That's affirmative, and we want you to maneuver.
Basically, the sprawl continues up the river all the way to Kyoto. Seems more or less continuous on the map.
Okay, you want to see the DAP of 2/10.
Okay, that DAP load, Fredo, is 3-1-1.
Okay, let's turn.
Okay, 3-1-1-2-0.
Interesting building over here, the roundish one. I'm not sure what that is, probably a stadium?
Give you an attitude to go to a burn attitude, and from thence we can get a star check. If you don't pass, we'd like you to do an alignment at
there's Osaka Castle somewhere around, but
and if you are ready to copy, we have some sun half unit vectors and some
there it is, to our left. I think that must be it. That would make sense.
Stand by, one show.
That with that lake around it. Yeah.
Okay, go ahead for 75 hours, sun and earth half unit vector.
Raj, first with the sun for X plus 4548.
Not totally sure what this round thing is, but yeah, I mean, some sort of sporting facility would normally be the thing.
For zebra plus 08262, earth half unit vector.
I think that's Kyocera Dome, Osaka.
Plus
I think that's what
three,
that is.
2-1-2-0. Minus 3-4-1-5-5. Minus 1-7-3-7-0. Over.
Okay, we need to fix our mixture now as we are descending.
4-5-4-8-3, R2 plus 1-0-0-5-3, R3 plus 0-8-2-6-2. Earth half unit vectors, R1 plus 3-2-1-2-0, R2 minus 3-4-1-5-5, R3 minus 1-7-3-7-0.
Roger, Fredo, good read back. Now, on the Earth, we estimate it will, if you have to do this alignment, that the Earth will be about a 2-degree Earth, and it'll be approximately 3/4 lighted. Now, to mark on the Earth, we'd like you to take an imaginary line between the horns.
It's a pretty big city.
And mark midway.
Pretty big harbor. I mean, the harbor is really extensive.
Okay, we got a 2-degree Earth that's 3/4 lighted, and we're to imagine a line between the horns of the Earth and mark right at the center of that line.
That's affirmative. Now, on the star check, correction, the sun check, Fred, at on the 5018, I got some FDA angles for you if you're ready to copy, over.
Okay, you're talking about the check at 74 hours GT, right?
Roger. Okay, it's 74 hours. When you start this maneuver, the 5018 should look like R1 of 2703 degrees, pitch R2 is 0903, and R3 of 2908, over.
How about making those all five digits read them again, Charlie?
Okay, pardon me. It's 27030, 09030, 29080.
Keeping eye on that engine gas temperature still.
Okay, the 5018 should look like R1 plus 27030, R2 plus 09030, R3 plus 29080.
Roger, good read back. Now, we got one more procedure for you, and right now we got the rendezvous radar stowed, and we won't be able to see anything out of D-10-2, so we'd like you to position the radar to zero.
Well, because I took sort of a sightseeing loop, the flight ended up a little bit longer than it necessarily needed to be.
Okay, go ahead.
Stand by. Aquarius, Houston, on those 5018 angles we had at 74 hours, Fred, that was based on a Vert 49 to this attitude, and they will be incorrect for the two-axis maneuver, so you can just scratch them over.
Okay, you're saying the angles you gave me for the 5018, that was for a Vert 49. So they won't be good for the 5018, and we should scratch them.
That's permanent. Okay, if you're ready to copy, I've got this rendezvous radar procedure, over.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, it's about a 10-stepper, but real easy. Okay, on CB16, EPS, inverter 2, close. CB11, AC bus A, bus tie, inverter 2, close. Panel 14.
Oh, we see the airport now. And across from the airport is Izumisano. That's the city name with that prominent tower there. Actually, that particular area is called Rinku Town. And I think that means link. It's Rinku. But anyway. Link Town. No, we're going way further up than I wanted.
Step 7. Monitor movement with verb 16, noun 72.
Well, that's a crosswind.
Step 8.
And I don't think there's any avoiding it.
Rendezvous radar 2, open. Are you with me, over?
And I'm just going to go ahead and try and land. I mean, it doesn't matter which direction we try and land at this airport, we're gonna get a crosswind. That's at 12,000 feet though. Maybe it's not so bad down here.
Okay, go ahead now.
Roger, step 9 is a verb 44. Step 10, CB16, EPS, inverter 2, open. Over.
Okay, I got it.
Okay.
Read it back now.
I got one more for you. If you'll copy this and give me it all on a read back. Okay, once you get to attitude and you want to use the get the AOT lamp, we got to go CB16 EPS inverter 2 close, CB11 AC bus A AOT lamp close. After the P52,
across the bay there you can see Kobe.
You can open.
We've basically taken the loop
CB
around.
CB16 EPS inverter 2 and open CB11 AC bus A AOT lamp and AC bus A bus tie inverter 2. Over.
Okay, stand by one. Okay, let's see if I got it all for rendezvous radar.
Where the heck are those poppy lights anyway?
We want CB16 EPS inverter 2 closed.
Like, that looks like they're right in front of the runway.
Bus A, bus tie, inverter 2 closed. Then on panel 14, verify inverter 2 selected. Then CB11, rendezvous radar 2.
Let me just get a look from outside here.
Both breakers.
That doesn't help at all. We might overfly it and come around the other way.
On panel 3, we then went rendezvous radar to LGC. Bird 41 down 72 enter with plus all zips, plus 283.00 and registers 1 and 2. Drawing that, then we monitor movement with the 1672. After it gets parked, it's CB11, rendezvous radar.
Maybe those aren't poppy lights, maybe those are just runway lights of some kind.
Then CB16, EPS inverter 2, open. Now when it comes time for the alignment to get an AOT lamp, CB16, EPS inverter 2, closed. CB11, AC bus A, AOT lamp.
Well, the wind must not be quite that strong down here, otherwise we'd be much more substantially blown off course.
Open. CB11, AC bus A, AOT lamp, open. CB11, AC bus A, bus tie inverter 2, open.
Good read back, Aquarius. To get those needles on the Verb 62, we got to power up the commander's FDAI. We'll have that procedure for you shortly. Over.
Charlie, Jim here.
Roger, go ahead.
Have you run a Earth-Sun alignment in a simulator with dock configuration?
Is the question, have we run a an alignment in the dock configuration? That is affirmative.
Okay, did you have any trouble controlling the vehicle, and what techniques did you use?
Briefly, to control pitch and roll, use the TTCA as we've practiced. For y'all, you can use the ACA. Over.
Okay, you have no special techniques going back and forth between...
It's a set of poppy lights.
The X and Y lines,
Not right now, Jim. Dave Scott's been running these things, and we'll get them up to
usually I expect them to the left of the runway. Oh, it is. Okay, that's all. That's not a runway. That gray part is just some sort of beach. Okay. I see a little stripe coming out on the water now.
Check does not pass since you are in attitude for the sun. That we want the sun half unit vectors first. Over.
Roger, understand. Okay, Houston, it's been over an hour since we did our last BTC, you want us to go another one now?
Standby one, over. Aquarius, Houston, we'd like you to go ahead and yaw 90 for the PTC. Keep a close eye out on your middle gimbal angle. We're about 30 degrees from gimbal lock, and we'll call you an omni switch halfway through the maneuver. Over.
Roger.
Okay, in Houston, Aquarius, you might know when you've had enough ranging so we can get the power amp back off again.
Okay.
Roger, Fredo, we got one more procedure, and we can...
That's a bumpy runway. That's not a properly flattened runway.
And the FDAI for this maneuver, that 5018 could take you to gimbal lock, and we think...
Good thing this thing stops relatively quickly, but... it's no SR-71 that has to deal with most of that stuff, but looks like the left portion of the runway is less bumpy, maybe? Let's hope. The crosswind is rough.
Okay, verify that you got AC power. In other words, the inverter 2 selected and the bus tie, inverter 2 AC bus A closed. Okay, under flight displays.
Out.
Gasta closed.
Okay.
Commander, FDAI closed.
Okay, I see a taxiway there.
CBs, Gasta closed. Commander, FDAI closed.
Such as it is.
Okay, it's verify we have AC, which is panel 16, inverter 2 closed.
Spark plus a fouling, okay, raise them to an RPM.
Then on panel 11 under flight displays, we want to get
this is bumpy.
FDAI breakers closed. Also under panel 11, AC bus A, our gas and commander's FDAI breakers closed.
That's affirmative, over.
Wow. How did these airliners get up there? Anyway.
Houston. After the Omni switch,
did I collapse
like
the tires are just blending in, I think.
Voice,
I'm just checking for damage, after all, considering the condition of the runway. Okay, as of that, over, I'm going to pause right there, and that's where we'll pick it up next time. But here we are at Kansai Airport in Osaka, and we're going to go for Chubu next time. In a PBY Catalina, hopefully, if that plane works properly. So with this, I'll say thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please do press like. If you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the comment section below. And I'll see you next time.